So after getting Train Sim World 2020 out of the way, it is only fitting and expected that an optimization guide video for Train Sim World 2 is next, right? Yes, that's correct. Today, in this video, I will show you how to improve the FPS numbers in Train Sim World 2 for a more pleasant and smoother gameplay experience. Without any further ado, let's get to it. This is not a typical benchmark video that will show you what it's like to play the game on certain hardware. This is a video that will show you what it's like to improve the performance of the game on certain hardware. Before we proceed with the optimization process, you will need to download and install the Low Specs Experience. The download link can be found in the description of this video. Low Specs Experience is a game optimization tool that I developed that will allow you to optimize your favorite games for maximum performance. So first of all, start the installation process for the Low Specs Experience. Once it's done, start it from the newly created desktop shortcut and select the optimization catalog. From the top of the menu, select the applicable digital platform and then select Train Sim World 2 from the drop-down menu. Once that is done, press load the optimization package. Low Specs Experience will now automatically check if the game version currently installed is supported by this optimization. If it is, press OK and the optimization control panel will load. When the optimization control panel loads, simply select the optimization presets and the resolution you would like to render your game at. This is something you will need to experiment on your own in order to see what works for the system the best. Once you decide which optimization presets and resolution you are going to use, press the Execute Optimization button and then start your game. Also, if you are not satisfied with what you see, you can always restore your game to default settings by choosing the Restore Default option. That's all from me for now. If you like what I do, please be sure to like the video and subscribe for more similar content. Anyway, I will see you next time.
One of the most successful diesel locomotives ever constructed, and the type remains in service. Almost all trains on the Cane Creek subdivision use two or more locomotives on the head end. We thus have to set up the diesels accordingly as lead and trailing units. Let's start by climbing aboard the trailing unit, which is the one farther to our left. Any trailing locomotive must have its control stand disabled so that it can receive commands from the lead unit. Check that the control, fuel pump, and engine run switch are in the off position. Trailing units also need to have their brakes set to cut out in trail 6 or 26. This is the default setting for all running locomotives at scenario start, so we can move on to the lead engine now. This is our lead engine. In other words, the unit we'll be operating from. We must thus switch on its controls. Our engine's controls are now active. Now we need to set the brakes for lead and the cut in to freight, which we can do with the two valves on the side of the control stand. Our two engines are now ready to run. Insert the reverser, set it to forward, release the brakes and apply some throttle. Then drive to the destination marker and stop there. The path to your destination has been set for you in this scenario. Please be aware that there are numerous manual switches on the Cane Creek subdivision, and the engine crew must always ensure the switches ahead are aligned properly for its movements.